Good evening. Thank y'all for being here. My name is Marcy Cohen Ferris. I'm interim director of UNC's Center for the Study of the American South. We're proud to be one of the co-sponsors for this evening's very special performance, along with Cat's Cradle, Schoolkids Records, and Yep Roc Records. The Center for the Study of the American South is a vibrant hub for research, dialogue, and collaboration. We're focused on a diverse and changing South. Scholars, students, musicians, documentarians, and community members work with the center in our core programs. The Southern Oral History Program, which documents the U.S. South by recording and preserving its compelling voices, and Southern Cultures, a quarterly journal and that also has weekly digital features that presents the region's leading thinkers, writers, and artists. In 2024, the Center and Southern Cultures will celebrate their 30th anniversary, and the Southern Oral History Program will celebrate its 50th. And it's going to be a landmark year, and maybe you guys will come back special for that. The center is also home to the Pan University program, Southern Futures, designed for UNC students, faculty, and the community, as well as the Critical Ethnic Studies Collaborative. So tonight's concert premiere of A Brand New Shade of Blue is a song cycle by Chapel Hillian Chris Stamey. Listen for the musical influence of North Carolina's own John Coltrane. A Brand New Shade of Blue was composed as warnings of the pandemic grew, and it was finished in the thick of its reality. It was recorded of necessity, one instrument at a time, in early 2020, often in quickly made at-home kitchen studios. The world ground to a halt, as we all experienced, but artists, in times of trouble, have always found solace in making art. Tonight, we bring the musicians together for the very first time. So please turn off your cell phones. Please hold your applause until the end of each song. And thank you. Please enjoy A Brand New Shade of Blue.
Thank you. goes a tree. But beside my discovery, they pale and can't compete. I thought that I had seen it all, but I know thank you. malady for which I cannot find a remedy. I only hold you fast. The chemistry agreed. The very nearness of your touch, your voice reminds me that I have no choice. Je ne sais quoi.
like strangers we meet by chance and then we pause. Oh, you're that I saw you there across the road. You waved and you laughed at someone in the car. A light turned to green and then we pulled apart. Are we meant to be a story?
Thank you.
should I bring a coat? There's so much to do. I'm so busy too.
Thank you.
As a hush once more falls on the town, the man in the moon returns no sympathy. And the street light on the corner still flickers off and on, and you can tell that it's keeping time in a minor key. It's still keeping time in a minor key.
Isn't it nice when there's no talking? You can just sit and enjoy the music. This was the point where, in my list of to-do things, I was going to think of something to say to you all, but I don't really have anything that the music isn't saying, I hope. It's been fantastic to do all this with these exemplary players, and I'm going to introduce everyone to you at the end. And let's see if I had anything else. Yep, that's it. We'll talk to you a little bit later, okay? We've finished side one of the album, and we're just getting into side two right now.
fell. called me out earlier, so I guess it's my turn. And ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for Mr. Chris Stamey? I've had the pleasure of working with Chris and have known him now for 12 or 13 years, and I realized just this week that's the longest working relationship I think I've ever had with another individual. And I've learned a lot from him just about being in his presence and watching over those years, and two things stand out to me. One, I think he's as humble a person as you're ever gonna meet. And two, I think there's nothing that he can't do when he sets his mind to it. I know Chris from the world of rock and roll music, and production, and all these things that he's known and done through the years, but when he started bringing these songs out, I was struck with how truly original it was. Other people do, a tip of the hat to the music of an era, and it feels like pastiche, or they're doing bad covers, you know, trying to resurrect a career. Chris is doing something completely new and original, and writing in that vein is just this fascinating exercise. It's really refreshing to me as a writer, to me as someone who's interested in making records, and we're just really lucky to have him in our community. So I just wanted to share that and thank him for the invitation to be part of this tonight. And I think this song kind of embodies that in a really wonderful way. If you wander off around the globe, perhaps Hong Kong, the old Silk Road, just remember when the night grows cold, come home to me. They say Tokyo is very nice, I like Berlin, I've been there twice. Greenland's great, but when you're tired of ice, come home to me. Sign that you've returned. The coast is clear and you can be sure the whole fire's burning. Serengeti, climb K2, track a Yeti. Just remember when you're good and ready, come home to me. I'll watch out for a telegram or fad, but Morse code's fine if the lines are kissing those dots dashing. Ride a barrel over Angel Falls, count crocodiles in Senegal. But when you have finally seen it all, come home to me. Come home to me.
If you know what to look for, there's a dream around the corner, no matter where you
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to be hosted by UNC for this and all our sponsors. It means a lot to me. I spent some time in this room, I think it was before it was converted to a stable back in the 70s, and it was quite different. For one thing, there was no air conditioning. Stage went up about here. And I think the last time I did anything in this room, there was an aisle down the middle originally, and all these very comfortable red pleather chairs or something. But we used that aisle for a tape delay, and the only way in those times you could get a long delay was to have two tape recorders set, and we had them about 40 feet apart, and we had a tape loop that stretched all the way down the aisle from one Revox machine to the other, analog tape machines, and so the tape loop would go. It would take it that long to get to the next machine, and it was a piece for saxophone, so the saxophone would go boop, boop, boop. And then as he was playing the next phrase from the back of the room, it would go beep, boop, doo, doo. You know, nowadays you just kind of tap on your phone and that happens, but so the room is much improved, and UNC is moving ahead. But the tape recorder was kind of a marvelous thing. I'm going to try to introduce everybody to you, although some people have lit out. Will Campbell was a great partner on this record. Fantastic. He's highly accomplished, who never lets that get in the way of his heart.
I'm sorry?
I said you're highly accomplished and you never let that get in the way of your heart. And really, my partners in crime, these guys have been giving me a liberal arts education by moving sound waves around. Steven Anderson. Jason Foureman. My hero, Dan Davis. And someone who was really my partner in a lot of this record, and in a very fragile and precious time in March and April of 2020, never let up on it and played wonderfully at every moment remotely, and we would have to send things back and forth, and I don't think you can tell it, and it's Charles Cleaver.
Yeah.
Truly fantastic. McKayal Phillips I met this afternoon. And I woke up this morning and I wrote out charts for several hours and made some coffee and fed the cats. I sent them to her about 11. Thinking she would flip that I'd written all this intricate stuff for all the songs, and I said, "Did you get that?" And she said, "Yeah, no problem." And really, it hasn't been. Alex Upton. I would say he's a rising star, but the star is already so up so high. Ben Robinson, fantastic. Ben's all over the record too. I made him put a mute in his trumpet, and he overcame it. Evan Ringel, fantastic trombone. Emma Dunlap-Grube, nailed it, tell it. Matt Chicurel and viola, my favorite instrument.
Sarah Griffin on violin. And Laura Thomas on first violin. Rachel Kiel on flute, also a mainstay in the making of this thing. We met Brett Harris. So let me tell you something about text messages. I love Ramunė so much, and I had trouble pronouncing her name. She sent me the exact way to say it, and my phone deleted it. And now I think I'm too low on blood sugar to get it right. Will you tell us what it is, Ramunė?
Marcinkevičiūtė.
And did I get everybody?
Or not anybody, right?
We can do that later. I mean, Jesse, of course, and Jay are fantastic. Thank you, everyone here. So, Ramunė, if you're still speaking to me, will you sing another one? Is that okay? Okay, we're going to do an encore tune, and after that, we're not going to play anymore, but I actually have some very rare vinyl. There are some vinyl copies of this. It was a short run. There are about 60 left in the world, and if you want one of those, I'll sell them to you after the show. It's pretty nice, you know, it's like round and you can put it on the turntable, but it's beautifully done. The no talking thing was maybe better, but I'm gonna go back to my chair now. There's not a cloud in the sky.
are together, the sunshine. I'm light as a feather, a balloon off its tether, drifting high. There's not an ocean so and pulled by the tide. We're just along for the ride, you and
all. And thank you all, and we'll see you again. Good night. And if you do want a record, I'm going to make it out there.